Good afternoon, students. Today we are discussing the second topic of road accident. First topic is the cause of road accidents that we have discussed in the last class. And the cause are road users, vehicle, road condition, road design, environmental factors and other causes. Next is accident studies and records. In the case of accident study, the first step involved is accident data collection. This is the first step. And the data collection of accident is primarily done by the police. Okay. And the motorist accident reports are secondary data. And these are filed by motorists themselves. And this data, the accident data collected should involve following parameters. First one, general. It involves date of accident, time, person involved in accident, classification of accident like fatal, serious, minor, etc. These are the general details which is to be collected. Second one is location. Location means it involves description and detail of location of accident. That is the location where accident occurs. Third one, details of vehicle involved. And it includes the registration number of vehicle which is involved in the accident, description of vehicles, loading detail, vehicular defects, if any. Okay. Next, fourth one is nature of accident. That is the detail of collision, damages, injury and casualty, etc. Nature of the accident. Then fifth one, road and traffic condition. It includes details of road geometry, surface characteristics, then type of traffic during the accident, then traffic density, etc. These are the features of road and traffic. Sixth one, primary cause of accident. These are the details of various possible cases which are the main cause of accident, and the causes we have already mentioned in the last class. Okay, that are the cause of accident. The last one is accident cost. Means the financial losses occurred due to the property damage, personal injury, casualty, etc. That is the financial loss occurred during the accident. And these are the data which is to be collected, or these are the features which is to be collected for the accident studies. Okay, that is general, location, details of vehicles involved, nature of accident, road and traffic condition, primary cause of accident and accident cost. Next is the purpose of this data collection. Why we are collecting this data and the or objectives of data collection. First one, identification of location points at which unusually high number of accidents occur. That is, we have to identify the location where maximum number of accidents has occurred in the past. That is the first purpose. Second one, detailed functional evaluation of critical accident location to identify the causes of accident. That is, we have to evaluate the areas of accident. Detailed functional evaluation of critical accident location to identify the cause of accident. In order to find out the main reason of accident, we have to do a detailed functional evaluation of the spot. The second objective, to find out the cause of accidents. Third one, development of procedure that allows identification of hazards before large number of accident occurs. That is, as a precaution, we have to identify the hazard before large number of accidents occurs. We have to develop, make a development procedure that allows identification of hazard before large number of accidents occurs. That is, we have to make a precaution to prevent the accident. For that, we are collecting the accident data. And the last objective is development of different statistical measures of various accident related factors to give insight into general trends, common casual factors, driver profile, etc. That is, using this accident data, we have to make a statistical measures or statistical report which involves general trends of this accident. That is, we can prepare a statistical map which indicates the variation of rate of accident in different years. Okay, or any type statistical analysis we can develop using this accident data. So development of these statistical measures, and it can and this statistical output may involve general trends of accident, common casual factors, driver profile, etc. Okay, any of this data, we can produce statistical output. For that, we are collecting the accident data. These are the main objectives of accident data collection. Next one is accident record. That is, the data we have collected is to kept in different record, different forms of record. And the first form is location file. Okay, location file means this is the file. This file is maintained by using the location of accident as the basis of order. This file is maintained using the based on the location of accident. Okay, a file is maintained for each intersection and for each area between intersections. Each report is then filed chronologically for each site, and these files are ordered chronologically for each site. This is the this figure shows the stacking of this location file. Okay, we are making a location file based on the location of accident, and is arranged in chronological order. Okay, that is location file. That is first type of, or one type of accident record. Second type of accident record is port map. These port maps are designed to show the complete road net on an installation or any specific part of the road net. That is, we have to here we are focusing the spot or the location where accident occurs. The traffic section post accident location on the map by using different colored map pins. Using different colored map pins, we are spotting locations where accident occurs. Color of the pins can be used to represent different factors. Map should be large enough for easy visit. It should be large. By viewing these maps, high accident locations can be seen. In this map, the areas having which is of high risk, medium risk, low risk can be easily identified using this spot map. Okay. By reviewing this map, high accident locations can be seen. At the end of each year, maps should be photographed in color and filed for future reference and comparison with current maps. Okay. Each year, we are referring this file with the next year accident data. Okay. Likewise, we are using this, we are making the spot maps in color. This sample spot map. It is here we have marked the as in dot, that is first dot without any filling means vehicle and vehicle, a collision with vehicle and vehicle. Then this circle with one intersection, vehicle and pedestrian accident, vehicle and bicycle accident. That is, type of accident is marked in each spot. So by visualizing this spot map, we can identify which type of accident occurs and which is the location where maximum accident has occurred. Okay, this is the use of spot map. Okay. Then third type is condition diagram. Okay, a condition diagram is a diagram which is drawn in a scale. Okay, it is drawn in a scale and it provides an accurate picture of the physical conditions present at the location under study. That is, it mainly indicates the physical condition of the location where accident has occurred. This is a condition diagram. It mainly indicates the physical condition of the area. From this diagram, the required visibility distance for the 85th percentile speed on the road and the actual visibility triangle can be made. Using this condition diagram, we can produce a visibility triangle. Okay, what is the importance of visibility triangle? This visibility triangle I have discussed in intersection. Okay, that is visibility triangle. That is, the driver should have clear visibility to the intersection. There should not be any obstruction in the line of sight. Okay, so by using this condition diagram, this is an example of condition diagram. Here visibility triangle is made. That is, this will allow an evaluation of the effects of obstructions on the driver's view and road accidents. This condition diagram actually evaluate the effects of obstructions on the accident. Okay, that is the reason or the obstructions which caused the accident is clearly evaluated using this condition diagram. And these observations and measurements should include, that is, this condition diagram should include the physical features of the roads, and they are curbs, roadway limits, property lines, sidewalks, driveways, view obstruction on corners, physical obstruction on roadways, ditches, bridges, traffic signal signs, pavement markings, street lights, grades, road surface, types of adjacent property, regularities, etc. That is, these all are the physical features of the roads, and this will be clearly understood by this condition diagram. Okay. And condition diagram may indicate that view obstructions are contributory cause of the accidents. from this condition diagram, this condition diagram indicate that the view obstruction is the main reason behind the accident. Okay. A driver proceeding at normal speed on a street should be able to see another vehicle approaching normal speed from the intersecting street. Obstruction reduces this ability. If there is any obstruction, the driver cannot be visible, so it may lead to accident. So this condition diagram indicates that these obstructions are the main reason behind accident. Next, a driver should have the time and visibility to react and brake a vehicle. Any obstruction increase the stopping distance. Okay, if there is any obstruction, it will increase the stopping distance. And this figure, next figure shows the sample of condition diagram. That is here, the visibility triangle is drawn. Drivers, if there is any obstruction for the driver's visibility. Okay, this is an example of condition diagram. Okay, so this condition diagram actually represents the physical features of the road. Then last type is collision diagram. Okay. This collision diagram permits study and analysis of a particular intersection or curve at which number of accidents have occurred. And this diagram consists of an outline map of the location and symbols showing the direction of movement of vehicle and pedestrians involved in the accidents. This actually indicates the intersection details, that is the movement of vehicle, movement of pedestrian and direction of movement, etc. That is collision diagram. Okay, if there is an accident, if accident has occurred in that area, this collision diagram indicates the movement of pedestrian or movement of vehicles and the direction of movement, etc. Okay. If stationary objects are important in accident, they are also included in the diagram. Okay, if stationary objects like trees, sometimes the accident may occur by colliding a vehicle on a tree. At that time, this tree is important in the accident, so it should also be included in this collision diagram. That is the the features which are involved in this accident is shown in this collision diagram. And the plots of accident should include direction of travel, date of accident, time, road conditions, weather conditions, any unusual conditions like flood, storm, intoxications, etc. These are the details which is to be included in the collision diagrams. And this is an example of this collision diagram. Example of collision diagram here, mainly the direction of movement is in, shown, and also date of accident, time, and I think it is not clearly visible to you in textbook also. This is collision diagram is given, so you just go through that textbook, that is Ghenna and Gesto textbook, accident study and analysis. Okay, and this is the these are the different types of methods for recording accident. Okay, location file, spot map, condition diagram and collision diagrams. Okay, this location file, here this file is maintained by using different location and is arranged in chronological order. And the spot map actually indicates the area where accident occur and type of accident, etc. That is indicated in the spot map. And in condition diagram, the physical features of the roads are mainly highlighted. This condition diagram, that is visibility of the drivers at intersection is mainly highlighted in condition diagram. And in collision diagram, the direction of movement and date of accident, extra indicated. Okay, so I am winding today's lecture. You should read the textbook and I will share this PPT later. Okay, thank you.